It's not only planes, but snacks and beverages you're into. I get my kalbi in Hong Kong and my pretzels here in Manila, potato chips in Bangkok, and the C2 in Ho Chi Minh. You've gone well before the ASEAN integration became a buzzword. Where is URC right now when it comes to the ASEAN regional strategy?
I think starting from the start, we've always, even from 20 years ago, my father had the vision and the imagination, if I can put it, to say we've been very successful with Philippine brands in the Philippines, and we should build these same brands in the ASEAN. And now, we're instead of selling in a market of 100 million people or our on-the-go products like Jack and Jill or C2, we're now covering a market of 600 million people across 10 nations. And we've been extremely successful abroad, building dominant businesses, particularly in Vietnam and Thailand as well. Last year, we made a big entry, went a further step by acquiring the Griffin's business, which is the number one biscuit and snacking business in New Zealand. And this will give us a premium brand, which will which we are planning to roll out into the ASEAN as well in that coming year. Well, it's already in Singapore and Hong Kong, and by June of this year, we hope to see that in. We hope to see New Zealand's best biscuits in the Philippines as well by June of this year. So we're quite happy. We've been able to build our international business to over $800 million U.S. dollars, which is a large business in itself. No?
What about Indonesia, though? I mean, you've mentioned your biggest markets as Vietnam, Thailand, and New Zealand with Griffin's. But what about Indonesia? Because you've managed to make some money, like $40 million U.S., but it's such a huge market, like a quarter of a billion consumers there.
It's still
so much opportunity.
It's still the holy grail of the ASEAN, no? I mean, Indonesia is about 240 or 50 million people, so definitely it's an imperative for us to build our business there. I think we're well on our way. We've essentially tripled our business in the last 3 years.
Up 30% in 2014.
And again, another 25 or 30% in 15.
How about this year?
If we're able to achieve our plans, then hopefully we grow another 20 to 25%. We built a Piattos there, which is a potato snack, into one of the top three snacks in Indonesia. I guess on that basis, we'd really like to build a sizable business in Indonesia over the coming years. No?
And your plan is also to be close to your consumers because you've got manufacturing sites in 5 ASEAN markets and distribution businesses in 4. Outside ASEAN, you've got New Zealand as well as China. Now, this exposes you to some forex risk because of the mix of currencies that go into that. With the forex volatility we're seeing right now, what sort of a risk would that have in revenue contribution for Universal Robina?
I think it's really, the Philippines is, if you look at all those currencies, actually the Philippines is the strongest currency among all these markets. So you're seeing that revenues you generate in Thailand and Indonesia, when you work it back to Philippine pesos, it's not worth as much, no? So there is definitely some forex risk. But I think this is really part of the challenges you face in operating in emerging markets, and it's a risk that all of us have to face. And what compensates for that is really the inherent growth rates of all these markets, you know, very young, very vibrant populations. Frankly, I don't spend too much time worrying about that because we're really long-term players here. Now, our goal is really to build a business that will stand, a Philippine-based business operating in the ASEAN that will stand the test of time.
And also into the premium markets, do you think the ASEAN is ready for a premium brand like Griffin's? What is the strategy here as you focus on the premiumization of the
I think you're looking at increasingly, you're seeing pockets of the population, what we always talk about, the growing middle class, that are really looking forward to higher quality products. You're already seeing that, for instance, in noodles, where the market is beginning to appreciate the convenience and the quality of say cup noodles as opposed to pouch noodles. You're seeing that in coffee, where they're going from instant coffee to coffee mixes, and now ready to drink coffee. So we expect the same to happen in snacks, in chocolates, and in biscuits, and that's the objective of the bringing the Griffins brand into the ASEAN.
You've mentioned Griffins. That's one, the latest one that you bought. There's also a joint venture that you made between Danone as well as Calbee. What's going to be next on the acquisition trail?
We're always on the lookout. I think again, our goal is to really build on-the-go brands for middle-class consumers in the ASEAN, and people just want better quality products that suit their lifestyle, that offer them health and functional benefits, and anything that brings us towards achieving those goals, we will consider.
Would it be from the ASEAN market or perhaps somewhere in the periphery? The Asian market,
I think the areas where we want to operate are really the ASEAN and what you say, New Zealand, Australia. No? Those are the areas where we think we have certain competence and certain advantages. So we just have to build the right brands or find the right products to develop in these markets.
What about China? You're set up there. You've got a manufacturing.
I think in China we're probably a little bit late at this point. Unless something really attractive comes about, I think probably the better return on investment is probably in our backyard in the ASEAN, especially the Philippines. No?
Banking. There's a lot going on in the banking business here in the Philippines, a lot of partnerships as everyone's scaling up. I know that you took an interest in UCPB, at least you were looking at the books in 2015. What is the latest in terms of scaling up Robinson's Bank in 2016?
Yeah, I think banking is really becoming a business for where size is critical now, because the cost of competing, of complying with cost of compliance has increased, cost of participation has increased, not only in branch network but in technology and hiring top people to join the bank. So you really need to be have a certain critical size. So our group is committed to building our banking presence. We've doubled up the paid up capitalization of our bank, Robinson's Bank, to 12 billion pesos last year. We're determined to build up the portfolio, but we recognize also that we're a relative minnow in terms of the wider banking environment. So we do need to consider other options, including looking at UCPB if it is for sale to bulk up. No?
If it is for sale, so it's still ongoing. I mean, if it were up for sale, you would be first interested to acquire it.
I mean, we would certainly look at it. No?
Would there be other choices?
I think there's. We don't know how this is going to play out, but certainly the trend is towards consolidation. No?
In terms of being acquired or acquiring? What is the direction that you're looking at?
We want to remain in the banking.
Okay, you're so busy, you're in all businesses, banking, malls, snacks and beverages. You're everywhere. Do you even have time for yourself? What's your downtime like?
No, you know, as you get older, you realize you don't have to, the key to having a sustainable or happy life is you just really need balance. You know, you need time for work, and when you're at work, you better be there 100%. But you also need time for your family and for yourself. No, and
how do you find time for yourself?
I always leave time for myself spend reading, you know, working out and the like.
What are you reading right now?
Well, I just read this book on Elon Musk, and now I'm reading a book from Google, Laszlo Buck. I think he's the HR head of Google on probably Google's secrets on building a good team. No?
I'm surprised you said earlier when you're getting older. Do you feel that at all? You haven't even hit 50.
My kids remind me all the time.
And you are indeed reaching the golden age at the end of this year, when your birthday comes in November. What are you planning for that big day?
Actually, I'm not planning anything. Maybe my wife will plan something with a few friends. Yeah.
But because Dad plans every 5 years, you don't want to plan on anything on your big 50.
I find that really stressful planning these things. So I try to avoid unnecessary stress if possible.